Hibernate needs to ensure that all tables referenced in a query are up to date before executing the query. That means it has to flush all pending changes for these tables before it runs the query. Otherwise, the database would process the query on an outdated dataset and return wrong results. Hibernate not only handles this step automatically, but also tries to do that as efficiently as possible. Based on the query statement, Hibernate tries to detect which tables the query references. This is called the query space. Based on the query space, Hibernate decides if it needs to flush any changes to the database. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen. In this video, I will show you Hibernate's query spaces and explain how they influence the performance of your application. But before we proceed, if you're new here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you learned something new. That helps me reach a broader audience. The query space also helps Hibernate identifying the paths of the second level cache it needs to invalidate when using a modifying query to implement a bulk operation. Hibernate doesn't know which database records and entity objects are affected by it when you execute such a query. It has to invalidate all objects of an entity class referenced by the query space, for example, all cached chess player entities. If the query space is empty, Hibernate needs to invalidate the entire second level cache. Hibernate generates the executed SQL statement for JPQL and criteria statements, and if you define the query via one of Hibernate's or JPA's APIs, for example, by calling the entity manager find method. In these situations, Hibernate detects the query space automatically and determines if it has to flush any changes. Let's get into the IDE and give that a try. In the following example, we find and update a chess player entity. After that, we execute a JPQL query that only references the chess tournament entity. The query space of my JPQL query only includes the chess tournament, but not the chess player table. Due to that, Hibernate doesn't flush the chess player entity to the database until you commit the transaction. That changes if you also persist a new chess tournament entity. Hibernate now finds a pending change and decides to flush the persistence context. One of the main advantages of a native query is that Hibernate doesn't parse it. That enables you to use all features supported by your database and implement very complex queries. But as so often, this also provides some drawbacks. One of them is that Hibernate doesn't know which tables the query references. The query space is empty, and Hibernate can't check if it needs to flush a dirty entity. Due to that, it always has to flush all dirty entities. Let's replace the JPQL query from the first example with a native SQL query that selects the same information. Hibernate now flushed the dirty chess player entity before it executed the native query, even though it wasn't necessary. To get the same optimized behavior as provided for a JPQL statement, you need to tell Hibernate which query spaces your native query references. You can do that via Hibernate's synchronizable query interface, or since Hibernate 5.3.20 and 5.4.24, by setting the query hint org.hibernate.query.native.spaces. The management of query spaces is a proprietary Hibernate feature, and JPA's query interface doesn't support it. You need to unwrap it to get Hibernate's synchronizable query interface. It offers multiple methods to specify the entities or database tables referenced in the query. Based on the provided query spaces, Hibernate can then check if it needs to flush any changes to the database. In this example, the query and the changed entity are independent of each other. Hibernate decides to delay the SQL update statement until the end of the transaction. Since Hibernate 5.3.20 and 5.4.24, you can also provide the query space as a query hint. The main benefit of this approach is that you can use it with JPA's query interface. You no longer need to cast it to one of Hibernate's proprietary interfaces. You can set a query hint by calling the setHint method on the query interface with the name of the hint and its value. Most names are long and hard to remember. I recommend using the constants in Hibernate's QueryHints class to make your code easier to read and write. Like in the previous example, Hibernate now knows the query space and decides to postpone the execution of the SQL update statement. You can also use the two previously discussed options to set the query space for native modifying query. Hibernate will then use the query space to determine if it needs to flush any entities and limit the invalidation of the second level cache to the affected areas. If you don't provide any additional information to Hibernate, the query space is empty. Hibernate then flushes all dirty entities and invalidates the entire second level cache before executing the SQL update statement. As explained before, you can provide the query space as a query hint or by setting it via Hibernate's API. Hibernate then flushes the chess player entity and updates the second level cache when the transaction gets committed. Flushing the persistence context and invalidating the second level cache can have a huge performance impact. That's why Hibernate tries only to perform them when it's absolutely necessary. To do that, it checks if the persistence context contains any pending changes that affect the query space. If that's the case, Hibernate flushes the pending changes. Hibernate automatically detects the query space if it generates the SQL statement itself. And if you're executing a native SQL statement, you should set the query space. You can provide it as a query hint or by calling one of the methods on Hibernate's synchronizable query interface. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!